Hi everybody, I'm Marina. Welcome to my Ceramics Oasis channel. And today I'm going to tell you how to build vase for dry plants from air dry clay. For this project, you will need any container, glass or plastic container to support vase walls. So I select this plastic one. And first step, I'm going to wrap it by just regular paper and use tape. Okay, next step, I will need pattern for my vase, and I use marker, and I'm going to make it asymmetrical, so probably something, and biomorphical, like this, and I will use this piece, and I will trace it. Okay, here's my clay. It's air dry clay Aurora brand, very nice clay, very similar with regular clay, and I'm going to make slab. Check size, yeah, it will fit. Okay, flip. Flip again. Okay, process. And my goal is to make this slab nice, smooth, and even. Okay. My pattern almost fit here. Perfect. So I use knife and cut my slab and leave extra space to overlap the slab. Next step, I'm going to smooth it. I dip my sponge in water, squeeze it, and smooth. Okay, next step, I will cut pattern, like flower pattern or snowflake pattern to decorate the surface. One more flower here. And tiny one here. Okay, so for next step, I'm going to smooth all these petals. I can dip my fingers in water and smooth it, or I can use sponge. Also, you can use brush, dip your brush, and you can play around inside of these petals. Please don't overwet your clay. Okay. Next step, I will need any plastic. I use press and seal, but you can use any. And place my plastic here on the top of my pattern. And I'm going to flip it. So I will decorate this surface more. First I will smooth it, and after it I will add some leaves, and I'm going to use coffee beans to add nice texture. Okay, so for leaves, I'm going to take piece of clay and make shapes like petals, flat them. For this clay, you don't need to use slip, so you can add just water and press your details, and they will stay, because this clay has a lot of glue inside. And I love to use leaves different shape and different size. Might be some of them longer, wider, or more round to show variety. Use water. And also few circles. Okay, next step, I'm going to dip my sponge again and smooth edges again. And I will use my best friend for drying. Okay, now I will use beans, coffee beans. Just press them. Okay, and I have to remove them. Take it off. As you can see, I got beautiful texture here. Okay, next step, I will add extra texture using this tool. Okay, and I will add few dots. And I would like to add texture around this edge. So I keep this tool and just press it. Okay, now I can move my slab from my workspace and my table, bending wheel, Very gentle, very, very gentle. I remove plastic from bag and stretch a little bit and wrap my bottle. So, use water here and connect two parts together. Overlap them slightly. Okay. And I would open this, make it more wavy, more biomorphic. Okay. If it's too wet, you can use hair dryer and now I can remove bottle from center and dry this again. Paper. And dry it again. Let's check circle. It's supposed to be circle on the bottom. Okay, it's still soft. So I should be very, very careful. Okay. Dry it again. So next step, we have to add bottom for our vase. Okay. Place my vase on the top and trace first. Okay, and I'm going to cut this circle, but I'm going to leave extra space to overlap my bottom over walls. Okay, so I will need to add water. Place my vase in the middle and gently overlap it. Okay, and I will repeat similar texture like I use here. So use my tool and just press. Okay.
Okay.
So I finish and I will let it dry for a couple days and after it I will paint it. Thank you. See you in a couple days. Hi everybody. After a couple days my project is completely dry. So I'm going to paint it. And I would like to preserve clay color because it's very nice, beautiful light gray. And I will paint just a few details and I will use metallic acrylic paint. So I think this golden one and dark chocolate will work match very well with clay color. And I select tiny brush. Okay. So I will start paint from a few leaves. You can use one layer or you can apply couple for best coverage. Depends on your taste. Also, I decide to paint coffee beans texture to show this passage over whole my project. And I'm going to use some golden color. Actually, I found it's too big contrast and I will switch to another one, to medium reddish brown. Yeah, much better. And finally, I will add just few yellow dots. So I decide it's good time to stop. That's enough. I don't like to overload this. And I will let it dry and will create my dry flower bucket. So here's my project. I found few beautiful branches and create my unique bouquet. So look around and decorate your house with beautiful project.